And the goodwill to work on the hackathon for the last 4 days almost. And now that this is the final, even like the team should present in 10 minutes their results, and there should be a discussion. Afterwards, the jury will, for let's say half an hour, sit together to evaluate the results, and then we will come to you back, tell the results during the closing and winning ceremony. So I'm not going to be any longer. Thank you again, and the floor is yours for the presentation of first team. So,
thank you. Thank you for, first of all, thank you for staying here and for listening to us. Again, we are the Pellich group. As said here, in English, our team, the name of our team is Integrated Watershed Management Program, Programa de Gestión Integral de Comunicación Geográfica. Y los miembros somos Héctor López, Octavio Doy, y los demás integrantes, Federico del Cid, Diego Gatica y Guadalupe López. Y Marco Ostellos.
Gracias.
We are focused in two lines of future investigations. one of that is the study is create and evaluate a model to study snow cover in Cordillera de los Andes, and the other line is referred to different variables of climatological variables that affect different crops. Now, Hector will continue with the first part.
Okay. The first line of investigation, I may resume for the process of the MODIS imaging that we download from NASA site. Weekly download at HDF images. We read the snow albedo variable with tool like HDF view, for example. We process the data with Excel and macro developed by the group. We view the result in tab like global mapper or QGIS, presented, create informative part, and modeling the metric forecast for the period October to September of the next year. Okay. And we participate in the media and academic field of the result. This is important because San Juan needs have a forecast of smell of the snow for working year after year. This is an example of imaging models downloaded 30 September 2018, sector H12B12. This image has a problem, has a lot of cloud content, so we discard this kind of image, and we process like this, October 15, that can be processed very well because the cloud is reduced, so we can show the snow. Then we select the machine and can be processed. Data is extracted with reading tools from HDF files such as HDF view. Then we use that file in MATLAB, CLAB, R, or Excel. Then that CVS file is processed with an Excel macro the macro is developed by Pellich Group. It's quantifying the cell with snow, adjust the cell with cloud, and divide different areas such Los Pato, Castaño, Calingarte. The results are processed and the part are reported and presented in the graph where we can see how 2007 was a good year and 2004 was a poor year. That is historical, we process in the group. The impact of the forecast for San Juan is important because it's directly related to the annual distribution of the water or for consuming or irrigation and energy, okay? These are the ERA files that we use to obtain an alternative validation method to improve decision making. Okay? This is the snow cover, and this is the no albedo. This is the Python code we use to learn that images. Data extraction in CSV format, for example, can be done with tools such as Panoply or similar, also with Python libraries, and try to use the macro we developed to with that file. This is a view of the ERA file Snow Albedo in San Juan in the digital model. This is a geo references with our layer that we use. And this is used to make a comparison with the file that we have processed with WASPOS. This is MODIS from NASA over digital model, and this is ERA file over digital model too. Simple visualization, this has more resolution of that. Okay, so, but the difference is that it's a reanalyzed data and this is a raw data. So, it's a good start to analyze that form. This is a Python algorithm to extract a point. That's the point in la zona Los Patos. The file is Snow Albedo 2018, and we have a average of the mount. Okay. This is ERA 5, and that is all process data from MODIS. This is for Snow Albedo. So the time you see, this is mount. 5 and 5. The accumulation of the snow started at the same time. Okay, so the visual validation is what for that variable. This is a snow core. It started at the same time, same month, 5 months. The cover variable is less than we have. And this is a snow deep. It's better the approximation visual. ERA file and MODIS file that we use in page. This is another point, La Cuenca Rio Castaño. This is ERA 5, and that's MODIS. We made a comparison of ERA 5 data with data measured in the field, in the station Pachón, in La Cordillera de los Andes, in 2007 year. See, this is ERA 5, it's not deep. This is real data in Estación Pachón. The visual comparison is very good in that. This is snow cover, and that is Estación Pachón. Conclusion, Copernicus system allows you to download data in a very simple way. Despite the difference of the scale of model, the comparative are very good, especially in the variables not deep. Snow deep variable with accurate measured data is very good. It's cool, allow calibrate or switch model in both directions. The ERA 5 data provide a high quality of information because it's reanalyzed. Another line of research is to use MERRA 2 or JRA 55 data to compare different models to ERA 5.
Well, finally, to conclude this part of the this line of investigation, the objective is improve and develop more the macro or the system that we use to evaluate the snow from MODIS, but to study the information from ERA 5. The information from ERA 5 is very good, very precise, has a very good comparison, as you see, with the information that the station in Pachón take. Well, the other line of investigation is analyze different characteristics of the weather here in San Juan, and create the final objective is create a ponderation to create a map with a productivity index to know what area is better than other area to grow different kind of crops. In this case, we had a comparison between the rainfall from August to January. Our province is a province with the dry weather, with the most rainfall is in January, with the medium precipitation about or around 100 millimeters. The other option that we have to analyze and compare to get the objective are the temperature, the different the range between the minimum and maximum temperature, and the median temperature. The other are the grace days. We need this information to know when we have to harvest the, in this case, the grapes, but we can apply to every kind of crops. And this, with the information downloaded from ALOS 3D work and different kind of floors in our province, we can get a final, our objective is create a final map with different productivity of index, like this one. This one is a map that now exists, but our objective is take the information from ERA 5 to create the same map and compare the different index productivity in our province. That's all. Thank you.
Thank you. If there is any questions from the jury first, I guess, or comments. Or just I spent a bit of time with you, so I'm aware of the project. But which kind of tool you used for the 3D visualization? For the 3D visualization, you used which tool?
In the map.
I don't understand what, but.
You had there some 3D visualization
for the presentation. Google Earth.
Google Earth.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
And well, Google Earth, and to analyze the information, which is
yeah, yeah, separate from that. Okay.
What's the high difficult to with the data?
Well, at the beginning, the most important problem was the process to download the information. We had some problems with the Python, but after that we solved that, we start to improve our work and get a lot of information to analyze and complete our objective. Some question more?
So if there's no more questions, and thank you again.
Okay,
thank you.
The deco cleanouts are the best team, so please change the computer.